Imagine being told that your home, your highland, and everything you know might soon vanish beneath the waves. The 2023 State of Climate Report highlights alarming new data on rising sea levels, particularly in the Pacific, where the situation is becoming dire. UN Secretary-General António Guterres warned.
Sea level rise is accelerating. It's not a double of what it was in the 90s. If we are not able to stop what is happening with climate change, this problem that we see in Samoa will not stay in Samoa. It will be happening more and more everywhere, in all coastal areas, from New York to Shanghai, from Lagos to Paris.
In the Pacific, sea levels have risen to 15 centimeters since 1993, nearly double the global average. This isn't just a matter of wet feet, it's an existential threat. The World Meteorological Organization warns that rising waters are pushing entire communities to move, contaminating drinking water, and eroding land that families have called home for generations. But rising waters are just one part of the problem. Warmer oceans lead to more frequent and severe storms. The Pacific alone saw 34 major weather events last year. John Kerry, Special Presidential Envoy for Climate, stresses.
We need to realize that no conversation about the ocean is about the ocean alone. You cannot separate the ocean from the climate crisis, and none of the climate crisis can be dealt with without the ocean solutions and vice versa. Harmful emissions are making our ocean warmer, more acidic, less productive, and we are driving rising sea levels.
Meanwhile, thousands of miles away, the Arctic ice is melting at a rapid pace, contributing to the rise in sea levels. Celeste Solo, Secretary General of WMO, points out.
Glacier's loss was the largest on record last year. These are the water towers of the world. They are our fresh water reservoirs. Sea ice depletion in the Antarctica was one of the major climate facts recorded in 2023.
This isn't just a local issue, it's a global crisis that requires a global response. So what's been done to combat this crisis? Programs like Weather Ready Pacific Program are providing early warning systems to help communities prepare for natural disasters. Yet, only a fraction of Pacific Island communities have access to these life-saving tools, leaving many exposed to worsening conditions. Chief Guterres, speaking with urgency, captures the essence of the situation.
I've seen firsthand the impact of sea level rise, crippling drought and devastating floods. Loss and damage is happening now. We need a concrete global response that addresses the needs of the world's most vulnerable people, communities, and nations.
The Pacific Islands are more than just beautiful locations. They are home to vibrant cultures and histories. Rising sea threatens more than just land. They threaten a way of life. This is a call to action. The tide is rising and it's time for the world to respond. This is Ifeoluwa Daniel reminding us all that the fight for the Pacific is a fight for our global community.